तो जो होता है अच्छे के लिए होता है. ओके तो अतिशयरी, हाउ लॉन्ग आर वी टू गुड टू गो?
Well, we are about to go live, and hopefully in another minute we can start. Shubho moy, Shubho, Shubho, kaha ho? Kothai, Shubho boy?
Yes, kothai? Sir, I am here.
Oh yes, you are here. You are all set. Great, super.
Good morning, all.
So, good morning. Yeah, good morning. Ki awaaz kuch zordaar nahi aayi, kuch maza nahi aaya, kuch enthusiasm nahi aaya.
Gaane ke liye rakh rahe hain ji.
Is it that ninja technique जो अपनी सारी एनर्जी समय पे यूज करने के लिए बचा के रखते हैं?
Guys, we are live now on Facebook. We are live on Facebook, Chitra.
Okay. So we start, and I am very, very excited today that the Digital Stories Championship is now live. And it is being by MS Talks, and MS Talks in India has been instrumental to provide a platform to the common people and share the voice of India. MS Talks promotes public speaking, storytelling skills, presentation skills, and importance of communications. MS Talks has been doing various events. You know, of late they have done so many events that I am all excited and being a part of it. And they've covered major national dailies of India with more than 250 events offline and given platform to more than 20,000 speakers from India and globally. Atishari, this is indeed a big number, and I want to really, really applaud you for this. Thank you, Atishari, for creating this platform. And Digital Storytelling Championship aims to unleash the hidden potential of the individuals, provide you with the international platform, and to promote yourself as a public speaker. Wow. And we are looking for storytelling championship, and anyone who is willing to be a champion can is showcasing their talent here. Okay, through this championship, we are creating awareness for the importance of storytelling. As we all know that storytelling has been there from the time we remember, from our ancestors, and so many people we have heard and learned so many things only via the stories, and that is what we always remember. What is told in the form of stories gets engraved here, and this is an opportunity for all of us to unleash our potential. Storytelling Championship is curated by MS Talks, our very own founder, president, author Sherry, and now I would like to thank our jury members. I can see some great people from the domain here. First and foremost, I would like to welcome Ms. Neerja Singh. Neerja ji, a very, very warm welcome. Neerja ji is a professional speaker on generational empathy. This is something that is very new to me, Neerja ji. I would want to know more about it. And she is also a magazine columnist. She's also social sensitization catalyst. And a little one thing I know about Ms. Neerja is that she's a power woman. I've heard her, and she has a fantastic voice. I want to compliment you for your voice, ma'am, and a terrific presence in front of the camera while you speak.
Thank you, Chitra. Thank you very much. Thank you, Author Sherry. Thank you, all of you. And today is my turn to listen. So I'm here to listen, not to speak. And I'm looking forward to sitting back and enjoying your stories and traveling with you wherever you're taking us. So thank you all very much. A pleasure, absolutely a pleasure and an honor.
I would also want to now welcome Ms. Seema Wahi, our honorable jury for today. She's an international storyteller. We just heard her. And she's also director of Storytelling Education and Arts India Council. So welcome, Seema ji.
Thank you so much, Chitra. Thank you, Author Sherry. It's an honor to be here. And I'm looking forward to listening to all the stories from all wonderful participants present here today.
Now I would want you all to welcome one more very very powerful person, and जिनके बारे में मैंने काफी कुछ सुना है, वो हमारे एडवोकेट सुभाष शर्मा जी हैं, and he is advocate in Delhi High Court. Welcome Subhash ji. He is also the general secretary and member of MS Talks, and also a part of the corporate advisory board. Subhash ji, a very very warm welcome to you, and it is indeed going to be a big experience for me, at least, to be among who's who today on the screen. And I really really thank author Sherry for bringing us all together. Now
thank you very much Chitra ji. Am I audible? No,
and now you're audible, sir.
Thank you very much, and I only give you all my best wishes to you, particularly because you have to organize the whole show for 2 days and present everyone in front of other people. And my best wishes to Nitya ji and to Seema ji, to very hard work. Out of 31 participants, you have to choose 3. It's not easy. But as in the beginning, Chitra ji has said that this is a learning stage. Everyone has to learn. This is my intent from the very beginning when I joined this MS Talk at the founding place, that learning has no age and learning has no end. The whole life is to learn. And when you say that they have to tell all personal stories, this is what is the truth comes out. How they have developed and how they have reached, it will tell other people also to develop themselves and to make a successful career. So with all these few words, giving my best wishes and all my best wishes to all the participants, and to present their stories, and let us hope for the best. Thank you very much, Itraji. Continue, please. आप शेरी जी म्यूट नहीं
हैं। Now it's time के थोड़ा सा हम हमारा एनर्जी लेवल बढ़ा ले, हम थोड़ा सा मूड चेंज करे, जैसे न्यूरॉन्स को ट्रिगर कर ले, क्योंकि कुछ जो पार्टिसिपेंट्स हैं वो थोड़े नर्वस है, कुछ हैं जो बहुत कॉन्फिडेंट है, तो लेट्स देम ब्रिंग देम ऑल एट पार एंड गिव देम दैट एनर्जी, एंड वी ऑल शुड गेट एनर्जाइज्ड. एंड इसके लिए आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम आवर परफॉर्मर ऑफ द डे, एंड जो पर्दे के पीछे है, सुभमय. ओ इज हियर, वेलकम सुभमय, एंड ही इज गोइंग टू परफॉर्म फॉर अस टुडे. एंड वो क्या लाए हैं हमारे लिए, वो मैं उनके ओवर टू हिम कर देती हूँ, सो दैट ही विल ओनली टेल अस व्हाट ही इज गोइंग टू शोकेस टुडे.
या गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, एंड वेलकम टू ऑल द व्यूअर्स हु आर वाचिंग ओवर जूम एंड फेसबुक. मेरे तरफ से आप सभी लोगों को मेरा प्यार भरा नमस्कार, प्रणाम, आदाब, सत श्री अकाल. आई एम फीलिंग रियली वेरी हैप्पी एंड ऑनर्ड टू बी एसोसिएटेड विद इवेंट, एंड विशिंग ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट टू ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स. सो हियर आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट अ ब्यूटिफुल बॉलीवुड मैशअप, होप यू ऑल विल लाइक इट. मैं रंग शरबतों का, तू मीठे घाट का पानी. मैं रंग शरबतों का, तू मीठे घाट का पानी. मैं रंग शरबतों का, तू मीठे घाट का पानी. मुझे खुद में घोल दे तो मेरे यार बात बन जानी. रंग शरबतों का, तू मीठे घाट का पानी. मैं रंग शरबतों का, तू मीठे घाट का पानी. शायरों से लफ्ज लेके थोड़े से उधार बोलना है, चाहता हूँ दिल से तुमको यार. हो रहा था, हो गया है हल्का सा खुमार. कोई ना रहा है दिल पे अपने जोर लव मी थोड़ा लव मी थोड़ा दिल धोखा धड़ी कर देगा सोचा न था इतनी ये गड़बड़ी कर देगा सोचा न था ऐसी मुश्किल खड़ी कर देगा सोचा न था उड़ गया तो तेरे तेरी तो उड़ गया तो तेरे ला 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 उड़ गया तो तेरे तेरी तो उड़ गया तो तेरे मनुष्य तेरा ले डूबा हर्ष तेरा ले डूबा मनुष्य तेरा ले डूबा हर्ष तेरा ले डूबा चांद भी वही है सितारे तेरे बाद फीके फीके लगते हैं सारे चांद भी वही है सितारे तेरे बाद फीके फीके लगते हैं सारे आजा लेके तू सवेरा कर जा दूर ये अंधेरा तेरी दूरी तड़पावे सोड़िया तेरे बिन नहीं लागे जिया तेरे बिन अब तो आ जा पिया तेरे बिन नहीं लागे जिया तेनु कितना मैं प्यार करा एक पल विच सौ बार करा तू जावे जे मैनु छड़ के मौत दा इंतजार करा बंदूर बनो मेरी चली ससुराल तो अखियों में पानी दे गई दुआ में मीठी गुड़ धानी ले गई हो बंदूर बनो मेरी चली ससुराल तो अखियों में पानी दे गई दुआ में मीठी गुड़ धानी ले गई रे कबीरा मान जा रे फकीरा न जा आजा तुझको पुकारे तेरी परछाइया माही बिन छड़ेओ ना के तेरे बिन दिल नहीं लगना जितना भी करना वे माही वे तेरे पीछे पीछे चलना तू जी सकता नहीं मैं जी सकता नहीं कोई दूसरा तो सरता मैं रखता नहीं क्या तेरे बाजू मेरा ओ माही वे ओ माही ये पहली बार मिले हम पे ये दम निकले हम पे ये दबानी धीरे धीरे मदम मचले हम्मा 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 ओ हम्मा 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 ओ ओ सिंग विद मी ओ
आपने क्या कर दिया सारा मूड कहाँ का कहाँ ले गए आवाज की मिठास एकदम एनवायरनमेंट में आ गई थैंक यू सुबह मैं ये तो वाकई में एक बहुत ही मतलब वाकई में ना एकदम शुगर डाइल्यूटेड मिल्क टाइप था एंड आई वाज वाचिंग ऑथर शेरी वो बहुत अलग मूड में आ गए थे ऑथर शेरी
ओह यस इनफैक्ट सुबह मैं तुम्हारे बारे में मैं तो एक ही चीज बोलूंगा यार, तुम लंबी रेस के घोड़े हो, अभी तो खेल की शुरुआत हुई है, अभी तो सारा आसमां बाकी है, अभी तो बहुत कुछ बाकी है, लाइफ में बहुत कुछ करना है अभी, यू हैव जस्ट बिगन, एंड व्हाट बेटर प्लेटफॉर्म इट कैन बी विद एमएस स्टॉक्स एंड परफॉर्मिंग विद अमंगस्ट द डिफरेंट पार्टिसिपेंट्स कमिंग फ्रॉम ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड, सो कुडोस टू यू, व्हाट अ वेरिएशन, आई लव द वेरिएशन.
यस, थैंक यू सर.
Now, Authorsheri, we would want to thank Subhamai for this performance.
Sure, yes.
And thank you, Subhamai, aapne time nikala hamare liye morning mein, hum sab ke liye. You know, what, there is one thing that cannot come back is time. And that is what you have given us. Thank you, Subhamai. Thank you so much and God bless you. Over to you, Authorsheri. I'm sure you also have the same thing to say.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you so much, Shubhamai, for your wonderful performance. It is a small token of love, your digital certificate. Please accept this from the entire MS Talks team. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir, for providing me this platform.
Shubhamai, shuruaat ho gayi hai, bhai.
शुरुआत तो हो गई है शरी जी, बट मुझे ना किसी के बारे में आपको बताना है. यू माइट नो हिम. आई नो अ लिटिल बिट अबाउट हिम.
ठीक है.
बट व्हाट आई नो इज लाइक व्हेन ही सीज अ प्रॉब्लम ना, ही गिव्स इट अ विंक एंड ही गिव्स इट अ स्माइल. एंड वो कहता है आजा लेट्स प्ले. या एंड इट्स नॉट ओनली दैट, कुछ चीजें अपनी लाइफ में चैलेंजेस उन्होंने खड़े किए हैं. And I'm seeing him moving like a spade, you know, miss those challenges. And that inspires all of us. Can anybody guess main kiske bare mein baat kar rahi hun? Koi guesses? Laga do, chalo laga do. Kaun hai? Chalo, main na unka mission statement batati hun aapko. somebody whom I've never come across. Authorsheri is not only a founder, a managing director of a public speaking institute, but he is someone who's chosen one to mentor all of us. Even I'm one of his mentee. And I would, you know, like to tell that वो 24/7 हमारे लिए available होते हैं, जब भी हम कहीं stuck होते हैं with regard to the subject, and even otherwise he is always there for all of us. And he is a 7 times international TEDx speaker, 3 times Josh Talks speaker, and author of international books, bestsellers. I mean, what else do we want? We have such a mentor like Authorsheri. And you know his mission statement. क्या है उनकी mission statement? 2030 तक कितने public speakers उनको ready करने हैं? कौन बताएगा मुझे?
1 million.
1 million, and 1 million is a big number. Big number which he has chosen, and I would like to you know salute him for this. And let's all put our hands together and. For our mentor, our coach, our guide, always, but you know, with a big, big heart, he's always there for all of us. Please give him a big round of applause. Unmute, wo awaaz aani chahiye mujhe.
Thank you, Chitra. I'm honored. Thanks, Itan. Thanks, everybody. Thanks, honorable jury. And thank you, Chitra. Thank you once again. Not limitless, thank you to you for introducing in such a way. All credits to you. And yes, you said it rightly, there's a lot of talent in India, and that is the reason I chose this mission of creating 1 million speakers by 2030. Before I start telling you about this competition more and this championship more, before we commence on absolutely on time, we are running absolutely on time, I would actually want to felicitate our honorable jury. They have taken their precious time. They are here with us and they are from the industry. So I would like to honor Ms. Neeja Singh first. Neeja ji, please accept my heartfelt gratitude and accept this online digital certificate.
Thank you, Authorsheri. Thank you very much.
Now I would like to honor Seema Wahi. Seema, thank you so much for coming and gracing. It's a pleasure to have you as one of our honorable jury.
My pleasure, Author Sherry. My pleasure, totally.
Thank you. Thank you so much. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, the day has finally come. We all have been waiting for. Storytelling is something which is very close to my heart, just like all of you. And I was just going through the categories you all have chosen. And as Seema has rightly mentioned in the beginning, most of you have chosen to speak on your personal story. Now, let me tell you something interesting about when you pick up your personal story. When you start living your story, listen to me. When you start living your story the way you want it to be, you transcend into something beyond your personality. And that is what the world needs, actually. Your personality, your power of vulnerability, plus the next level, which you can give back to the land where you belong. And this is the power of storytelling, ladies and gentlemen. I remember when I shared my story for the first time with the world, I was under tremendous pressure. I was very anxious that time, what will happen, how people will perceive it, how people will respond to it. And trust me, it all happened for the best. Not only I received several calls when people saw me on Josh Talks, not only people send me their best of the wishes, messages, emails. In fact, I also got a chance to work in a film in Punjab. Can you beat that? Somebody called me from Punjab to work in a movie just after seeing my Josh Talks. But this is not, this does not just end here. What happened after that was people started receiving me as somebody who is very authentic, who is very genuine, who is somebody who speaks by heart. In order to win this competition, it's a competition, my dear friends, it's a championship. We have created this under the umbrella of MS Talks India. We have several events. I have curated more than 14 events under the umbrella of MS Talks India. Now, if you really want to win the hearts of the people, as I said in the bootcamp, all you need to do is speak from here. Because when you speak from here, there is an automation of emotion. And emotion is the glue which causes the memories to stick in your mind. And I personally believe that when you start sharing about your stories, if you can just mix up things well with your smile, aura, energy, content, vulnerability, emotion, connectivity, sky's the limit. And hey, you just won it. So all you need to do is that whenever you are not talking, you're going to talk, just address everybody, just connect with everybody, and make sure that your story is going to bag you that title which you're here for today. All right, now I'm going to share the screen and take you through with a very, very brief introduction about the event once again. I hope the screen is visible to all of you. So these are the five categories. And I'm sure already people have selected their categories: historical story, startup story, personal story, corporate story, and business storytelling. So one of the categories you have to choose. And these are the score parameters. Jury have been already informed. In fact, they are going to watch strictly on these parameters, how you're performing. We have soft skill score, nonverbal, content, storytelling skills, and prop. Remember, the prop usage is mandatory to make sure that your talk is getting more impactful. It gets more vivid when it reaches to the hearts and minds of audience. And these are the categories of titles to be won. We have overall storytelling champion, founder's choice. Then overall storytelling champion for digital storytelling championship. Then first runner-up and second runner-up. So I'm truly excited about the fact that you all are excited. And I would like to tell you more about what we all are doing. Since we all knew that COVID-19 has been a blessing in disguise for most of us, but during these unprecedented times, I believe that some people have explored their true potential. We have got some wonderful soul-searching times, and people have grown exponentially. So in order to make a comeback in offline events, we are organizing another event that is coming up on 13th of March at a 5-star location in Gurugram. I'm going to show you a small video. Let's enjoy.
कुछ करिए नस नस मेरी खोले हाय कुछ करिए कुछ करिए कुछ करिए बस बस बड़ा बोले अब कुछ करिए ओ कोई तो चल सिद फड़िए तू बेतरिए या मरिए हाय कोई तो चल सिद फड़िए तू बेतरिए या मरिए चक दे पतंगों में भिड़ती उमंगों में खेलों के मेलों में पल खाती रेलों में.
So this was about the National Public Speaking Championship. We are officially launching about the National Public Speaking Championship. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for watching this video. And we are kicking off for this next event as the discipline we follow, that we announce it right before the, you know, the last event. So that's what we are doing. I'm looking forward to interact with the now multiple orators and some of the best talents in India, like we're going to do in today's competition of storytelling and storytellers. Now let me invite our anchor. So here's an official introduction for our anchor. We have Miss Chitra Vashyani. Chitra ji is, you know, she is actually someone who believes in creating the lasting impressions. That's what she believes in. She's an image consultant, an etiquette coach, and also the chapter president for Surat at IMPA. IMPA is image consultancy. Am I right, Chitra?
Allow me to go ahead.
Go ahead. Just
Image Management Professionals Association.
True. Super. Thank you so much. So Chitra, we are honored that you have taken the charge as an anchor, and we are really blessed to have someone with your experience. We would like to felicitate you as well online here for taking this opportunity, considering us worthy, and sharing your talent with us. Please accept this certificate of appreciation for your wonderful work. Thank you for being an outstanding host.
Author Sherry, thank you. But I would say that aap hamare guru hai. So, hamesha hum always we are there for this. Let me tell all of you all that I am one of the mentee of Author Sherry. And it is a wonderful experience to be here. And Author Sherry ki to wo video mein chak de India wala tha na, to unhone actually chak de, you know, India kar rahe hain. And ye jo josh level hai, अब बहुत ऊपर जा चुका है ऑथर शेरी, तो क्या हम आगे बढ़े? क्या हम आगे बढ़े?
और अब आपके साथ पूरा पॉजिटिविटी का फ्लो आ चुका है. सो ओवर टू यू. थैंक यू वेरी मच.
थैंक यू. एंड हमारा पहला स्टोरी टेलिंग कंपटीशन का फर्स्ट हमारा स्टार्ट होने जा रहा है, तो कौन होगा? ओके, सो आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट first speaker, our first participant of the day, Miss, she's from Delhi, And who could she be? Miss Sneha? Put your hands together for our first participant, Miss Sneha Kohan Kumar. And welcome, Sneha.
Thank you, ma'am.
Over to you.
Thank you so much.
And she's here to share her personal story. And let's start with something that connects to all of us very quickly. And they are the personal stories. Over to you, Sneha.
Thank you, ma'am. A very good morning to the jury members, lovely participants, and the positivity with the Miss Host. So tonight, my topic is age is just a number. So let me start from here like this. Oh, yes. Hello, everyone. So let me start something like this. कहते हैं जिसने हमें जन्म दिया, जिसने हमें चलना सिखाया, जिसने हमें उंगली पकड़ के दो कदम सिखाया, जीने का मतलब सिखाया, जीना सिखाया. आज मैं बात कर रही हूँ उस इंसान की जिससे मुझे बहुत मोटिवेशन मिलती है, जिससे मैं बहुत ज़्यादा इंस्पायर होती हूँ. मैं बात कर रही हूँ अपनी माँ की. जी हाँ, वो माँ जिसने मुझे जन्म दिया, जिसने मुझे सही मायने में जिंदगी का मतलब सिखाया. तो ये कहानी है, शुरुआत होती है 1997 में. हम लोग बॉम्बे से आते हैं. सो ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम वी हैव नथिंग, नो हाउस, नो जॉब, नो स्कूलिंग, नथिंग. हम सब कुछ अपना मुंबई में खो चुके होते हैं. कहते हैं कुछ एज के बाद लोग अपने रिटायरमेंट की प्लानिंग कर रहे होते हैं कि हम ये करेंगे, हम वो करेंगे. लेकिन कभी किसी ने सोचा है जिस टाइम पे लोग रिटायरमेंट की प्लानिंग करते हैं उस टाइम पे कई लोगों की नई शुरुआत भी होती है. जी हाँ, ऐसा ही कुछ हमारे साथ हुआ. शुरुआत में मेहनत बहुत थी, पोटेंशियल बहुत थी, लेकिन कहीं ना कहीं वो चीज़ नहीं मिल पा रही थी ना. एजुकेशन हर पेरेंट्स की एक ख्वाहिश होती है कि उसके बच्चों को बेस्ट एजुकेशन डिलीवर हो, कि उसको कभी लाइफ में स्ट्रगल ना करना पड़े, उसको वो सारी चीज़ें मिले जो वो डिजर्व करते हैं. तो ऐसा ही कुछ मेरी ज़िंदगी में हुआ और इसी से मैंने बहुत कुछ सीखा. तो ऐसी ही कहानी है मेरी माँ की. जब उनको घर भी मैनेज करना था, हमें भी मैनेज करना था, फैमिली को मैनेज करना इतना आसान नहीं था, लेकिन उन्होंने हिम्मत नहीं हारी. उन्होंने सोचा जब मेरे में कुछ करने की चाह है, जब मेरे में करने की कोई पोटेंशियल है, तो मैं क्यों ना करूं. उन्होंने नई शुरुआत करी, नई ट्रेनिंग लगी ली. वो हमेशा एक ही बात कहती थी कि कोई भी शुरुआत करने से पहले आपने अपनी उम्र नहीं देखनी, बिकॉज एज इज जस्ट अ नंबर. जी हाँ, जब आपको आपके अंदर करेज हो, पोटेंशियल हो और पैशन हो कुछ करने का, तो उम्र काम नहीं आती. आपका जज्बा, आपका जोश आपका साथ देता है. यस, ऑफ कोर्स फैमिली मेंबर्स टू. मेरे फादर ने मेरी मॉम को बहुत सपोर्ट किया एंड नाउ शी इज एंटरप्रेन्योर. वो अपना खुद चीजें खुद रन करती है. सो उन्होंने आज तक हम दोनों बहनों को एक ही चीज सिखाई है, लाइफ में इंडिपेंडेंट रहो, अपने लिए अपने पैशन को फॉलो करो. जो आपके अंदर करना है ये मत सोचो इसकी तो उम्र निकल गई. नहीं, इसकी कोई उम्र होती ही नहीं है. आप जब चाहो, जो चाहो, जैसा चाहो वैसा आप कभी भी किसी भी वक्त शुरुआत कर सकते हैं. ये क्या है, एक पेन, नोटबुक. ये एक दूसरे के साथ बहुत कनेक्टेड है. जब हम कुछ लिखते हैं इसके अंदर और जब हम उसको बार बार देखते हैं तो हमें लगता है नहीं, हमें कुछ करना है, ये चीज अचीव करनी है. सो वहां से हमें मोटिवेशन मिलता है. तो एक छोटा सा मैसेज है आप सभी लोगों के लिए, जब भी कुछ करने की चाहो तो उम्र मत देखो, मन में अगठानी हो तो उसको पूरा करो. थैंक यू सो मच.
स्नेहा, आपने तो वो जो कहावत है ना, द हैंड रॉक्स द क्रेडल रूल्स द वर्ल्ड, यू नो, उसका एग्जाम्पल यहाँ पर आपने रख दिया है, सॉफ्ट योर मदर. एंड यस, वो इमोशनल कनेक्ट, आई बीइंग अ मदर आई कुड वेरी वेल कनेक्ट विथ योर मॉम, आई बीइंग अ डॉटर आई कुड कनेक्ट वेरी वेल विथ यू. एंड आपने वो मुझे ना इस कुछ ही मिनटों में मुझे पीछे लेके जाके आप वापस ले आई. थैंक यू फॉर मेकिंग मी रीलिव दोस डेज एंड इट वॉज अ फैंटास्टिक स्टार्ट. एंड नाउ नाउ बिफोर वी गो अहेड आई वॉन्ट टू थैंक, आई रियली रियली वॉन्ट टू थैंक आर स्पॉन्सर्स, आर मीडिया पार्टनर्स एंड आवर डिजिटल पार्टनर्स. थैंक यू ऑल सो मच फॉर डूइंग एवरीथिंग फॉर अस. And now I would like to call someone from far away, from lot of distance, who is here smiling in front of us, all the way from US. Miss Meena Sharma, I would welcome you here, and over to you, Miss Meena.
Thank you so much, Chitra, and thank you so much, author Sherry Ji, and all the jury members. और मैं सबको मीना शर्मा की तरफ से प्यार भरी नमस्कार, सत श्री अकाल और आदाब. आज मैं जो आपको सुनाने जा रही हूँ उसमें मैंने डायरेक्टली तो नहीं वर्ड्स अपने यूज करे, पर वो मेरे और मेरी बेटी के साथ कनेक्टेड होता है, तो उसको फीलिंग्स को मैं इसमें लाने की कोशिश कर रही थी. तो अगर आप कहें तो मैं स्टार्ट करूँ.
प्लीज.
बेटी से ही आबाद है, बेटी से ही आबाद है सबके घर परिवार. अगर न होती ये बेटियां तो थम जाता ये संसार. सुनते हैं कि हर व्यक्ति के 100 भाग्य होते हैं, और उनमें से अगर एक भाग्य अच्छा हो तो उसके घर में बेटे का जन्म होता है, और अगर 100 के 100 भाग्य अच्छे हो तो उसके घर में बेटी का जन्म होता है. शायद इसीलिए ये कहा जाता है कि बेटा भाग्य से होता है और बेटी 100 भाग्य से होती है. और अगर आपको उस भगवान ने, उस परवरदिगार ने बेटी से नवाजा है, तो आप भी अपने आप को भाग्यशाली समझें, बहुत खुशनसीब समझें, क्योंकि बेटी पराया धन होकर भी वो पराई नहीं होती. शायद इसीलिए आज तक किसी पिता से हंसकर बेटी की विदाई नहीं होती. ईश्वर की सौगात हैं बेटियां, आंगन की चिड़ियां हैं, और जब वो चिड़ियां उस आंगन से उड़ जाती हैं तो तब आप महसूस करते हैं वो सन्नाटे जो आंगन में होते हैं और वो उदासी जो आंगन में होती है. तो ऐसे ही मैं आपको थोड़ा सा बताने जा रही हूँ कि एक बेटी ने अपने पिता से बहुत प्यारा सा सवाल किया कि पापा, अपने आंगन में एक पेड़ है, उसको हम पीछे वाले बगीचे में क्यों नहीं लगा देते? तो पिता बोले कि बेटी, वो 4 साल पुराना पेड़ है, नई जगह नई मिट्टी में वो चल नहीं पाएगा. तो ये सुनकर बेटी बोली कि पापा, आपके आंगन में भी तो एक पेड़ है जो कि 22 साल पुराना है, तो क्या वो नई जगह जाकर ढल पाएगा, रह पाएगा? तो पापा की आंखें नम हो गई बेटी की बात सुनकर, और उन्होंने कुछ सोचकर उसको बेटी को ये जवाब दिया कि बेटी, पूरी कायनात में सिर्फ नारी ही है जिसके पास ये शक्ति है. पूरी कायनात में सिर्फ नारी ही है जिसके पास ये शक्ति है कि खुद नए माहौल में ढल जाती है, औरों की सेवा करती है, और तमाम उम्र उनके लिए ही तो वो जीती है. और उन कभी उसके किरदार बदलते हैं, कभी वो बेटी होती है, कभी वो बहन होती है, कभी पत्नी और कभी माँ कहलाती है. और क्या चाहती है वो? सिर्फ थोड़ा सा रिस्पेक्ट और थोड़ी सी प्यार, वो दो चीजें चाहती है, और क्यों ना चाहे, इसकी वो हकदार भी तो है इन चीजों के लिए. माँ बाप का दर्द समझती है, माँ बाप को के आंसू पहुंचती है, बेटी भी तो माँ जैसी होती है। मेरा हिस्सा मत देना भैया, मेरा हिस्सा मत देना भैया, बस मेरा मायका जो है वो सजाए रखना। मैं इस घर की बेटी हूँ, मैं इस घर की बेटी हूँ, ये एहसास हमेशा ही मन में समाए रखना। जब भी पैदा होती हैं बेटियां तो अपनी खुशियां अपने साथ लेकर आती हैं, और उनकी जो किस्मत है वो उनको अच्छी जगह से लेकर जाती है। माँ बाप अपने पिता बेटी को सब कुछ दे सकते हैं, और अगर जो नहीं दे सकते वो है बस उनका नसीब, उनकी तकदीर। पिता का मन हो तो बेटी की राह से सब कुछ निकाल दे, उसकी जगह वो फूल डाल दे, पर बेटी जो है उसको तो अपना ताकत लगानी है, सारा कुछ करना है। तो मैं यही दुआ करती हूँ कि संसार में जितनी भी बेटियां हैं, जितनी भी बहनें हैं, परमात्मा उन सब की झोली जो है खुशियों से भरे, और उनके हमेशा ही नसीब जो है वो अच्छे करें। तो अभी हमें अपनी बेटियों के लिए बहुत कुछ करना है, तो आइए हम लोग इन नए साल के अंदर आपस में मिलकर अपनी बेटियों के लिए एक बेहतर कल बनाए, अपराध मुक्त हो और सुनहरा संसार हो, ताकि कोई भी बेटी कभी भी ईश्वर से ये मत कहे कि अगले जन्म मुझे बिटिया ना कीजियो, अगले जन्म मुझे बिटिया ना कीजियो। थैंक यू।
मीना जी, आपने तो मुझे रुला दिया ऑलमोस्ट, मैंने कैसे भी कंट्रोल किया। और ये जो आपकी लास्ट वाली लाइन थी ना मीना जी, वो बहुत दिल को छू गई। एंड एक पॉइंट स्पेशली अपराध, यू नो, अगर हम ये चीज ध्यान रखे कि आज की बेटियां हमारी नेक्स्ट जनरेशन को बिल्डअप करने वाली हैं, बहू बनके, मदर बनके, तो वाकई में ये चीज खत्म हो जाएगी एंड वर्ल्ड इज गोइंग टू बी अ वंडरफुल प्लेस टू लिव विद। Thank you, Meena ji. Thank you so much. I know it is very late in US. I would wish you a fantastic and a wonderful sleep tonight. Aapne bahut mehnat ki hogi, I'm sure, aaj ke liye. And you should get the rest and sleep. Thank you. And aage badhte hue hai, thoda historical, baatein bhi jaani jaye, thoda peeche jaaya jaye. थोड़ा माहौल चेंज करते हैं, थोड़ा वाइब्स चेंज करते हैं। मुझे बट रोना आ रहा था। आई वॉन्ट टू गो अहेड नाउ विद द स्टोरी टेलिंग चैंपियनशिप। एंड कौन आएगा, कौन आएगा, कौन आएगा? ओके, हम सतीश जी को बुलाते हैं आज। सतीश बाछले फ्रॉम हैदराबाद। सतीश जी,
हेलो, मैं ऑडिबल, मैं ऑडिबल?
यस यू आर ऑडिबल।
एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस यू आर।
सो टुडे लेट्स स्टार्ट अ हिस्टोरिकल वे ऑफ डूइंग द थिंग्स, द मिरेकल माइल्स। Before that, I just pay my regard to all the jury members, the fascinating and inspiring and motivating jury members. Thank you very much, given me opportunity to on this international platform. Thank you very much. Now, my story is like this, the Miracle Miles. It was never happened in the history of athletics that human being break the 4-mile barrier. And in fact, 4-mile barrier, that means 1 mile under 4 minutes, we have to perform the race. 1 mile is equal to 1.6 kilometer. In fact, all the scientists and all the medical scholars has proved that no one can run 1 mile under 4 minutes, it is just not possible for the human body. But in 1948, one athlete of the British has decided that he will do that, he would do that, and he decided that he can change the psychology of the whole world. And then he started, and he decided that he will run 1 mile under 4 minutes. He was struggling hard, doing all the hard work. Then after that, in 1952, that was the Olympic it was the Olympic in 1952 Helsinki, and he has created the British record and stood that fourth position in 1500 meter race. It gives me immense strength and motivation and inspiration and self-belief in himself that he can do it. He was working hard day and night, night and day, but he was not getting the result he wanted. In fact, one he was closely related and he was closely inspired and closely introspection, his analysis of the practice, he found that there was a strengthening of thighs muscles was lagging. Why? Because that in order to get a pace maximum, that for that he has to get maximum amount of oxygen from his heart and its flow to the body through the blood, and that is to be stronger, his that all nerves of that thigh muscle. Then he again immediately he has changed his tactics and his strategy of his practice, and now he was giving 50% of his time in that cardiac exercise and balance 50% of time in that strengthening his thigh muscles. After some time he was getting a desired result. He was getting the result. Then after that, the day has come on 6th of June 1954, that day has come for his running, and it was at Oxford, and he was started that race on that day. He was so much fast and he was total energy was on that his running, and that 3 minutes 55 seconds over, and he has completed his race and he has created the history. The 4 minutes, within 4 minutes, he's created that 1 mile. And after that, whole body was shivering. It was totally pain. And he was just like a breathless and whole body was dead. But his whole condition, whole pathetic condition was converted into pleasure when he heard that he has clocked the timing of 3 minutes 59 seconds and 4 microseconds. It was created the history, and that person was none other than Sir Roger Bannister. And that's Sir Roger Bannister has created the history. First time in the history humankind has created that history. He has break the barrier of 1 mile, and that is what within 4 seconds, that is what the history created. And my dear friends, this story has not ended here. Now the main story has started. Now just after 46 days, one more athlete done the same thing, and after two years, 8 more athletes has done that. And that from that point of view, that barrier was simple. It was not a barrier at all. So my questions to all of you, my ladies and gentlemen, why that happened, that all these athletes didn't thought about that before that performance, but after that seeing Roger Bannister historic performance, they have made the things happen. Why, my dear friends? I think, was there anything that can create the magic? No. What is that then, my dear friends? That is only one thing, and that was the mindset. That is the mindset of the Roger Bannister. It was a sky high, and the mindset of those athletes was only on that level of ground. And my dear friends, that is very, very important. And we are having in the life only two things and two choices. Either we want to become of those athletics who by seeing others' performance, then become and make the milestone, and you yourself become the Roger Barrister of your own life. Choice is only yours. Thank you very much.
बहुत ही इंस्पिरेशनल स्टोरी आज हमें सुनने मिली है. ऑफ कोर्स द लॉन्ग स्टोरी शॉर्ट, यहाँ पर हम एक ही चीज समझ सकते हैं कि एक बार जो हम ठान लेते हैं, जब हम कर लेते हैं, तो जो पेन हमने एक्सपीरियंस किया है विद इन अ फ्रैक्शन ऑफ सेकंड्स, दैट अचीवमेंट कन्वर्ट्स दैट पेन इनटू प्लेजर. एंड दिस इज द पावर ऑफ डिटर्मिनेशन एंड डिसिप्लिन, परसिवियरेंस. Am I right?
We are unable to see you. Sorry to intervene. Please check your video.
Am I visible? I'm sorry. Yeah.
It's all right. So, yeah, you are now.
So now moving on to our next participant from Chandigarh. May I welcome Ms. Ritu Katoj.
Thank you so much.
Ritu ji is here with us to share a personal story. Looking forward, Ritu ji. Over to you.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone. I'm very grateful for this platform. And today I'll be sharing my story titled An Ignored Story. I used to be a working lady and very strong-willed person. 4 July 2015, the day when I welcomed my first child and the mother inside me was born. I quitted my job and stepped into this wonderful journey of motherhood with lots of excitement. And guess what? Who welcomed me first? Postpartum depression. I was supposed to be 100% grateful and over the moon, but I ended in a dark and discouraging place. कुछ समझ नहीं आ रहा था दैट वेयर टू रन एंड हु टू आस्क अबाउट इट. स्टडी सेज दैट वन इन एवरी सेवन वुमेन फेसेस पोस्टपार्टम डिप्रेशन. 75% केसेस गो अनडिटेक्टेड विदाउट स्क्रीनिंग. कुछ औरतों को इसके बारे में या तो अवेयरनेस नहीं होती है या कुछ मेरी जैसी इसको एक्नॉलेज या एक्सेप्ट नहीं कर पाती हैं. पोस्ट डिलीवरी वुमेन की बॉडी में काफ़ी सारे हॉर्मोनल चेंजेस आते हैं विच डेवलप दिस पोस्टपार्टम डिप्रेशन. दोस्तों ये एक ऐसी बीमारी है जो औरत की खुशी होने तक, खुशी तक पहुंचने की जो क्षमता होती है उसको छीन लेती है ठीक उसी समय जब उसे इसकी सबसे ज़्यादा ज़रूरत होती है. और शायद कुछ ऐसा ही मेरे साथ हो रहा था. स्ट्रेस लेने की वजह से मेरी बॉडी में जो हॉर्मोनल चेंजेस आ रहे थे वो इम्बैलेंस में कन्वर्ट हो गए. एंड 15 डेज पोस्ट माई डिलीवरी माई बॉडी स्टॉप्ड प्रोड्यूसिंग मिल्क. It was brutal realization, left me devastated but also guiltier than ever. I was feeling failed on the very first step of motherhood. Many times people around me made me feel like an incomplete woman. Wo shabd aaj bhi mere zehen mein hai when I heard one of my family member talking on the phone ki joy mere bete ka naam. Joy ko maa ki zarurat kya hai, bottle se doodh to koi bhi pila sakta hai. और उन शब्दों ने मेरे गिल्ट को और गहरा कर दिया था. एंड दोज गिल्ट क्लाउड्स वर गेटिंग डार्कर अराउंड मी. ऐसा चलता रहा. आई एम गेटिंग इनटू पोस्टपार्टम डिप्रेशन. मैं इस फैक्ट को एक्सेप्ट नहीं कर पा रही थी बिकॉज आई वॉज फेयर ऑफ कॉन्सिक्वेंसेज, क्योंकि सोसाइटी में डिप्रेशन को एक डिस्ग्रेसफुल टैग दिया गया है ना. सो आई कंटिन्यूड विद इट. आई थॉट दैट थिंग्स विल गेट बेटर विद टाइम एंड टू मेक इट बेटर आई वॉज ट्राइंग हार्ड. And I was keep telling myself that I am okay. और इस पूरे प्रोसेस के दौरान ना आई वॉज लूजिंग कंट्रोल ऑन माई फिजिकल एंड मेंटल हेल्थ. लॉट्स ऑफ आर्टिकल सेज दैट पोस्टपार्टम डिप्रेशन कैन हैपन टू अ फर्स्ट टाइम मदर्स ओनली. बट लेट मी टेल यू फ्रेंड्स, आई वॉज ऑन द एक्सट्रीम लेवल ऑफ पोस्टपार्टम डिप्रेशन आफ्टर माई सेकेंड प्रेगनेंसी. बट इस बार ना एक्सपीरियंस थोड़ा डिफरेंट था. आई वॉज नॉट फीलिंग डिप्रेस्ड बट येस was facing severe anxiety, obsessive thoughts about my kids, and yes, behaving impulsive. Again, I choose to suffer alone. And I said, I am okay. I am okay. जब तक मैं खामोश थी ना तब तक जिंदगी चल रही थी, पर जब मेरी खामोशियों ने बोलना शुरू किया तो ऐसा लगा जैसे जिंदगी में बवाल सा आ गया है. उन दिनों my company was my anxiety and my panic used to tap my shoulder twice or thrice in a day. ऐसा चलता गया. सिचुएशन ऐसी हो गई थी कि लग रहा था कि क्या चल रहा है आसपास, कुछ समझ नहीं आ रहा है, रातों को नींद नहीं आ रही है, बॉडी वॉज एकिंग लाइक हेल. करीबन 6 साल लगे मुझे इस चीज़ को एक्सेप्ट करने में और अपनी जबान पर लेकर आने के लिए कि येस आई एम नॉट ओके, आई नीड हेल्प, एंड येस आई टुक मेडिकल हेल्प एंड क्वाइट डूइंग वेल दीज डेज. माई लेसन, डू नॉट attack your problems, accept it or confess it, because when the moment I confessed my problem, the next day I woke up different, and then I realized that I was not the only one, not the only woman who was suffering in silence. I belong to majority, and that day I decided to be the voice of all those ignored stories and will tell everyone that postpartum depression and anxiety are not disgraceful tags. These are just one wound that needs to be treated in time. Thank you.
Richu ji, aapne to itne sensitive topic ko itna gracefully le gaye aap. एंड एक पॉइंट जो मैं हमेशा सोचती हूँ, आज मैं यू नो एक्सेप्टेंस एंड अवेयरनेस ऑफ योर मेंटल कंडीशन इज हाफ द बैटल वन. द डे यू एक्सेप्ट एंड यू आर अवेयर ऑफ व्हाट यू आर गोइंग थ्रू एंड यू कम अहेड सीक हेल्प इज समथिंग दैट इज सम वेरी वेरी इंस्पिरेशनल दैट आई हैव लर्न फ्रॉम दिस स्टोरी टुडे. एंड इसके लिए तो वाकई में आपको एक जोरदार तालियां हो जानी चाहिए कि आपने ये ओपनली आपने एक्सप्रेस किया, एक्सेप्ट किया.
थैंक यू मैम.
पोस्टपार्टम इज यस रियली अ सब्जेक्ट दैट वी ऑल गो थ्रू एक्सपीरियंसेस. रिचु जी थैंक यू सो मच. इट्स अ बेस्ट थिंग दैट आई हैव एवर यू नो हर्ड टिल टुडे अबाउट दिस एक्सपीरियंस.
थैंक यू.
आई वांट टू से 3 words फॉर रिचु बिफोर यू प्रोसीड. And these 3 words are Richu is back.
Thank you. Yes. Thank you so much, sir. It means a lot. Thank you.
May I ask Seema ji about her views on this experience of digital storytelling by MS Talks? Seema ji, may we hear something from you?
It's amazing. Are you asking me?
Yes.
Yeah, this is amazing. And each story is so good. And this last story, it was so moving. You know, you could actually go through your own cycle of how you felt. So it's each story is evoking different emotions.
Yes, Seema ji, you are right. Mujhe bhi aisa lag raha tha jab wo bata rahi thi ki kahin na kahin main usse connect ho pa rahi hun. And wo experience jo wo tha unka, lekin रियलिटी ये कि हम सबका ये एक्सपीरियंस होता है पोस्टपार्टम डिप्रेशन जो होती है एंड वी समहाउ कम आउट ऑफ इट सक्सेसफुली एंड वी ऑल आर हियर. सो द कमबैक यू नो
एंड द ब्यूटीफुल वे शी सेड आई एम नॉट ओके एंड शी टोर इट यू नो.
यस, द एक्सेप्टेंस एंड अवेयरनेस ऑफ व्हाट शी वाज गोइंग थ्रू. ओके नाउ लेट्स थैंक यू सीमा जी. थैंक यू सो मच. आई वाज जस्ट वेटिंग टू हियर फ्यू वर्ड्स फ्रॉम यू. नाउ लेट्स invite our next participant from New Delhi, the little one, Miss Ananya Jain, and she has a personal story to share again. So we will again go down the memory lane with Ananya Jain. Ananya, welcome, and the stage is all yours.
It's Ananya. मेरे घर आई एक नन्ही परी, एक नन्ही परी. Yes friends, this was the song my parents sang when I was born. Good evening everybody. I'm Anya Jain and today I will tell you an important life lesson my mother taught me. On my board, I was a bundle of joy for my entire family. As my father doesn't have any sister, so everyone was super excited to have a girl child in their house. I was pampered by all. And then after 5 years of my birth, my mother gave me the best gift ever, a little sibling. An angel again arrived at our home. Life was very beautiful for me. I was so happy to have her that I named her Khushi. As time passed by, things began to change. My sister turned out to be a prodigy. She was exceptionally good at acting. And at the mere age of 4, she could solve puzzles meant for 6 plus. She was the talk of her family now. Wherever she used to go, everyone would say, Beta, bas ek app suna do. Hum tumhe Kinder Joy dilayenge. And then everyone used to burst in laughter after hearing her. Although I loved her very much, but somewhere I started feeling inferiority complex. Now I wanted to be like her. Not only like her, I wanted to be like my best friend who was good at dancing. I wanted to be like my cousin who was good at singing. I just wanted to be like others. As it said, one can't hide anything from a mother. Same happened with me. She got to know something is bothering me. So one day, she silently came into my room and gently hugged me. Then she narrated me a story. She said, once a plum asked God, God, can you please make me a banana? When God asked why, it replied that the guy loves banana very much. So God turned him into a banana. The guy purchased an orange instead. So the banana said to God, God, can you please make me an orange? God made him an orange. Then the guy came, picked up the orange, bit it, started saying, and then the orange said, how I wish I remained a plum only. There would be someone who would come and take me. My mother further added, we all are different. Our likes, dislikes are different. We have different looks, different nature. She said, my beloved daughter, you are an original. Why do you want to be a photocopy of others? You could get inspired from them, but do not imitate them. Discover for who you are. She said, you are you, my daughter, and we all love you the way you are. And since that day, the chirpy, bubbly Anya was back again. I stopped trying to be like others or somebody else. In my free time, I started to write poems, and my parents were astonished to see my compositions and encouraged me to write more and more verse. I would like to share one with you all. My parents, my pride. First time in their laps, I cried. They always pampered me a lot and never flaunt. Mom and Dad, the only thing I always had. With them, I never felt bad. What I want, they always got. And if I didn't understand anything, like a teacher, they taught. Thank you, Mom and Dad. This is me, the original Anya with original composition. And friends, it's just a good name. Thank you.
Ananya, kya khaya tha nashte mein? Mama ne kya khilaya tha? इतना जोश, इतना उमंग, कितनी प्यारी स्माइल है तुम्हारी. एक मौका मिलेगा ना, हम साथ में एक बार स्टोरी टेलिंग करेंगे. आई वॉन्ट टू शेयर द स्क्रीन विद यू. एंड मेरे घर आई एक नन्ही परी. वाकई में यू नो द डॉटर्स आर गिफ्ट ऑफ गॉड, एंड उनके आसपास होने से आई मीन लाइफ बिकम्स यू नो अ सॉन्ग, एंड वी ऑल कीप डांसिंग ऑन दैट. Ananya, thank you so much. It was
Chitra, want to ask her. Yeah, want to ask her. This was Chota Packet Bada Dhamaka.
Yeah, Chota Packet tha ye
to. Yeah, actually, she's Anya, not Ananya. So, Anya, ek baat batao. Ye jab microphone gir gaya tha yahan se kaan mein se, dhadam. Us logo ke dimag mein kya chal raha tha ki storytelling kar paungi, nahi kar paungi. Aise kuch aaya tha mind mein ki yaar to gayi beta. Ye kya ho gaya? Aise kuch aaya tha mind mein?
No.
Kya aaya tha mind mein? Wo batao na.
ऐसा कि गिर गया तो अब वो जल्दी से उठा पाऊंगी तो मेरा टाइमिंग खत्म हो जाएगा यानी।
ओके तो आपने प्रिपरेशन करा था इस स्टोरी के लिए?
यस।
ओके ग्रेट। और स्टोरी टेलिंग की प्रिपरेशन कैसे करी, थोड़ा सा उसके बारे में बताओ।
पहले तो मामा ने बताया कि जब आप छोटे थे आप ऐसे करते थे। So then I got to know about my childhood. Then she said we will make a story on this. So then she made my personal life story. I also got to know about my childhood. And then I learned it. So it was my personal story.
All right. Thank you, Anya. Over to you, Chitra.
Yeah, I would once again like to thank to our sponsors, our media partners, our digital partners. Thank you very much. Our sponsors, media partners, and digital partners. Everything is possible when we work together as a team. And this is a fantastic example. MS Talks is a fantastic example of the team that goes together, grows together under the mentorship of none other than author Sherry. Okay, now moving on to our next contestant, next participant, who is super awesome, super energetic, and super fantastic. Fantastic person. By now, all of us have guessed who the super person is, and the Superman and Super Sureshji. Over to you, Super Sureshji. And Super Sureshji again has a personal story, and we are looking forward to hear the story and to learn so much from him again. Over to you.
Thank you very much for this amazing introduction about me. Suresh to Super Sureshji was a transformation in my life. And today I'm going to share that personal story to everyone who's going to listen. And I know that this platform is very important for everyone. This platform I consider to be a very precious platform in my life because my life started in platform. My life started in platform, a railway platform, which made me to be in this platform. I was born in a village which don't have even a proper electricity in the year 1985. Even I born in the year 1985. That's how I was to this universe, to this world. And this world made me to learn many interesting things. And I really appreciated my parents for letting me to be free to learn something which I can be now as this. And because of that, I said this platform is very valuable platform where I can, and I really respect this platform where they are picking a people from a normal background to share the message to the world. And they consider each and every one as a super awesome energy and a superhuman being. And that's how my life started in 1985. And then my parents, they could not able to afford a very good school. And later they made me to study in a government school. And then after third standard, I wanted them. And they also looked at my way of learning and getting into the life. They borrowed money personally from the family members, and then they put me into a matriculation school. And then my game started, because I know that that school was a very big achievement for me, and I wanted to hold, and I respected, and I carried one thing from that day with me wherever I go. And that particular thing is helping me to reach out this world with confidence. And from third standard, I started to respect each and every teacher who comes and teaches me lesson without any hesitation, if there is 40 students in a class, I go, I touch the feet of my teacher and tell them to bless me, because I know that opportunity has not just came for me.
Suresh ji.
So teachers and parents and everyone, and there is no bad person in this world. Everyone is there to support one another, but the way how we look at them is what. And I thought I should not carry this, and I should carry a different tool, a different energy, and a different courage within me. I thought that will come only through the magic tool which I was holding. That's how I completed my school secondary, and then I could not able to pursue my college as well. And several reasons, I was going on a different kind of work, been a labor for TI cycles. I've been there for a daily wages. I've been there, and I thought education is the only tool which can enhance me and which can take me to a different level in my life. So I approached Madras University, which is in Tamil Nadu, and I completed my bachelor's in business administration. And while I was studying, even I was working for an organization as well. As a part-time, I was into dispatch department. And there I used my communication abilities, because it was a North Indian company where they don't speak Tamil, they speak Hindi and English. So I tried to learn Hindi as well, and I used English. I thought I learned myself, because to go and meet my boss, MD, he speaks Hindi and English. And he know that I cannot able to understand Hindi. So he helped me to improve my communication in English. And from there, he made me and he gave me a responsibility as a manager of the organization. While I was doing my undergraduate, I became a manager, because he knows that I've not grabbed the bachelor easily. While I was studying my schools and after school I was working, you know that this guy has got a very good energy, and always I showed him the magic energy I was holding within me. And that's how it all went in my life. And from there I stepped and I thought education is the only powerful tool which has transformed my life, that can help someone to transform in their life as well. And because of that, at present I'm a director, managing director of a private limited organization. I help people to study abroad, and I help people to get free education in Germany and in Italy as well. And you know, with a powerful tool, the powerful tool which I carry is my smile. Because of this smile, I attracted everyone, and I go on without any hesitation. Even 2021, with this powerful smile and with the same overcoat, the jacket coat, I met Author Sherry brother in Delhi, and that's how it all happened in life. So whatever the situation it might be, please carry the powerful smile what you have within you. And when Seema ji, she laughed, it was amazing. You know, without she showing her smile, she looked different. When she shows her smile, that is amazing. You know, when people are showing their smile, that is what the energy we need to carry within ourselves. No one is there going to do harm for you. Everyone is there to support you. The way you watch them, where you think about them, you need to change them. Why you need to think that they are going to do something harm for us? And thank you very much for this wonderful platform, a platform which helped me to start my life, and the platform is helping me to show the real energy and transformation that I could able to see in my life. If I can do, definitely anyone in this world can do this. Thank you very much for this wonderful opportunity, and I respect everyone from bottom of my heart. Thank you. Thank you very much for listening to me.
Super story.
Personal
super
story.
Energy. Super inspiration. Where there is a will, there is a way. Am I wrong? Am I wrong?
Nothing is wrong.
मैं ना बार बार कनेक्ट कर जा रही हूँ सारे पार्टिसिपेंट्स के साथ, एंड मुझे ना बार बार खुद को पुल बैक करना पड़ रहा है. आई डोंट नो व्हाई दिस इज हैपनिंग. आई थिंक सीमा जी हमें बता पाएंगी, मुझे नीरजा जी मुझे बता पाएंगी, ये कि क्यों इस तरह से हो रहा है आप प्लीज मुझे बताइए नीरजा जी सो दैट आई नो व्हाई दिस हैपनिंग द साइंस बिहाइंड दिस द रीजन बिहाइंड दिस व्हाई आर वी ऑल एबल टू कनेक्ट विद द स्टोरी सो वेल एंड हाउ डू यू कनेक्ट विद द स्टोरीज नीरजा जी नीरजा जी
Yes, Chitra, it is because it is a story and the stories are powerful because they resonate with each one of us. They are stories of struggles, stories of disappointment, stories of all the challenges that we go through. And that's what we are connecting with, all the emotions and the sentiments and the desire to excel. Each one of the participants is trying to stand out, to shine there on that stage. And that is reaching us. The only thing is, as a jury, I'm trying to take a little step back and not get blown away and begin to flow and be so overpowered that I lose my judgment. That's the only thing that I'm experiencing right now. But certainly these stories are powerful enough to carry us all together, and I'm enjoying every bit. Thank you.
Yes, I would really appreciate you for this. You know, you're trying to hold back the avalanche of emotions that you are experiencing while listening to everyone's stories. Thank you, Neerja ji, for sharing this with us. And now I would like to invite our next participant. And again, this participant is from Saat Samandar Paar with one more personal story. In line, and who could it be? Our one of our maybe Corona warriors, and I would like to invite Dr. Siddharth Kishore Gaur. Please present his story in front of us. Dr. Siddharth, over to you.
Thank you so much, Chitra ma'am, for the warm introduction. And before I start, I would like to thank you, Kara ma'am, for organizing this. I would like to thank all the distinguished jury members who have given us this opportunity on this platform to speak and invested their time. Truly means a lot. And last but not the least, Author Sherry, sir. Sir, they say that a good teacher teaches. A great teacher demonstrates. But the best teacher inspires. You have always inspired us to take action, break our limiting beliefs, and speak on such platforms, sir. I want to thank you for that, sir. And without further ado, sir, I want to just take 10 to 15 seconds to set up my prompt, if that is okay with you. So Kara ma'am, I'll be starting in the next 5 seconds. Today, I'm going to talk to you, all of you, about trusting the unknown. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. There is something common between you all and me. We were all born as babies, but not those babies that were born in some mythological soap out of thin air. Not even those babies that were sent from planet Krypton to Earth in a space rocket to become Superman or Supergirl. Not even those babies that were genetically engineered in a lab in a sci-fi Hollywood movie. No. We were all born naturally as babies with two basic qualities, trust and joy. To trust everyone and to live joyfully is the natural way of life. In fact, every child trusts everybody else until people like you and me, parents, teachers, media, instill patterns of fear in their minds, fear of the unknown. Where the unknown can be a person, thing, situation, environment. I remember when I was younger, I used to go out alone. My mom used to tell me, "Beta, khabardar, agar kisi anjaan se baat ki to, kisi se kuch lena nahi." And I used to say, "Ji, mummy." In short, do not trust strangers. But the unknown is inviting. The unknown is intriguing. Whether we trust the unknown or fear it completely depends on us. Even today, I'm speaking to all of you with a blindfold on. I cannot see you. I do not know most of you, but I still want to trust each and every one of you. Yes, you, you, and you. Because when you trust the unknown trusts you back. I remember when I had come to Dubai 3 years back, unknown city with unknown people. I used to avoid taxis because they're very expensive. I wanted to make maximum savings. That particular day, 52 degrees centigrade. It was so hot that even if you crack open an egg and put it on the road, it would turn into an omelet within seconds. I had finished my first sales meeting wearing the same black blazer, and I started walking towards the next one, becoming like Rambo. 8 kilometers apart. For the first 2 kilometers, I was fine. But then my head started spinning. My body started sweating profusely. My heartbeat started racing so fast that it was going to pop out of my ribcage. My mouth was running dry. I put my hand inside my laptop bag, took out my bottle of water, but that too was empty. I started praying to God, God, please rescue me from this situation. And just before I was about to collapse, a taxi with a well-built taxi driver stopped right next to me. And he opened the co-passenger side window and said, Bhai Jan, aapko kahin chhod dun? At that point of time, my mother's words of do not trust strangers started ringing in my ears. What if this guy robs you, Siddharth? What if this guy, even worse, molests you? I said to him, Nahi bhaijaan, main chalunga, koi dikkat nahi hai. To which he replied with a very soft tone, Bhaijaan, bahut garmi hai, aapko heat stroke ho jayega. Aap please aa jaiye, aapse paise nahi lunga. At that point of time, I decided to trust the unknown. I sat in the taxi, closed the door. To my surprise, he put the blower of the AC to the maximum speed. And even without me asking him, he gave me a chilled bottle of water to drink. And he dropped me to my destination without charging me a single penny. Today, Tariq and me. Yes, Tariq, the same Pakistani taxi driver. Yes, Pakistani taxi driver are very good friends. And till date, he drops me to most of my official customer meetings. Now imagine for a moment, if I would have not trusted the unknown at that particular day, probably I wouldn't be speaking in front of you today. I know what many of you might be thinking, come on, Siddharth, be practical. There are bad people on this planet. Yes, there are. In fact, they are so bad, they do not deserve a spot amongst humanity. But my question to all of you is, how many of you actually know a murderer, rapist, or a pickpocket? In my last 34 years of life, I have not come across them. Why? Because of such few bad people, we tend to generalize and make everybody look bad. Today, I'm in front of 25 people, good people with good soul, who are here today investing their time on a weekend to add value in the life of others and to their own lives and make the world a beautiful place to live in. In conclusion, I would like to quote Mr. Teal Swan. He says, we do not fear the unknown. We fear what we think we know about the unknown. All I'm trying to say are three things. Number one, trust the unknown. In fact, embrace the unknown. Number two, stop fearing the unknown, because when you do this, the fear in your mind reduces. You start working towards your goals, your dreams, your aspirations, and take yourself to easier heights of success. And last, believe and trust in the fact that there are good people and goodness still left in this world. Thank you.
Dr. Siddharth, आपका एक क्वेश्चन मैं इतनी खो गई उसमें कि हाउ मेनी टाइम्स डू वी मीट अ मर्डरर अ रेपिस्ट और समवन हु इज अ विकेड सोल. ये बात वाकई में सच है. आई हैव नेवर कम अक्रॉस सच पीपल. तो इट इज समथिंग दैट वी हैव क्रिएटेड इन आवर माइंड्स के सब खराब है, बट इट इज द अदर वे अराउंड. बहुत कम लोग ऐसे होते हैं, एंड देयर इज ऑलवेज अ रीजन फॉर पर्सन टू बी हु ही और शी इज. So let's not just superficially or, you know, on a very shallow way, judge anybody about knowing without, you know, their background and the reason for their why. And, you know, I was just waiting. आपने जब वो काली पट्टी बांधी ये वो, और मैं है ना देख रही थी सुभाष सर का रिएक्शन उस पे, एंड ही seemed to be so curious to know what next. Subhash sir, आपने क्या सोचा जब उन्होंने पट्टी वट्टी आपने आंखों पे बांधी with that black coat on him?
ये सोच रहा था कि ये बहुत बढ़िया कोई चीज आने वाले हैं. I was expecting some type of a story, no doubt about it. Just a minute. Yeah. I was just thinking that he's going to tell us a story like this. I knew this. I was anticipating that Dr. Siddharth would speak on something like that, that you should trust and not to trust, not to make your thinking like that. But very good, very good, very good, very good. I mean, this is a lesson to everyone. This is a lesson to everyone.
Yes, only it is a lesson like for all of us. Trust.
Mistrust of sare door hain, sare murder hain. Bahut achhi baat hai.
सही बात है, सही बात है.
थैंक यू वेरी मच. ऑल द बेस्ट, ऑल द बेस्ट.
थैंक यू सर, ट्रूली मींस अ लॉट. थैंक यू मैम.
थैंक यू डॉक्टर गौर. एंड अब हम आगे बढ़ते हैं हमारे नेक्स्ट पार्टिसिपेंट. उनका नाम ना बड़ा राइमिंग है तो मुझे ना काफी देर से मैं वेट कर रही थी वो नाम पढ़ के कि मैं वो बुलाऊं उनको. एंड समवन फ्रॉम जमशेदपुर again with a personal story. Again we are going to go on a beautiful journey of someone's life. Maybe go ahead, maybe go behind. kuch na kuch personal story hame kahin na kahin kisi zone mein leke jati hai hamare life ke. So put your hands together, I invite Miss Priyanka Prasad to come on the stage and share her wonderful story with us. Priyanka ji, please, may we see you, kahan par hain aap?
Good morning.
Oh, you have such a sweet voice.
Thank you. Shall I start?
Yes.
Okay. So, good morning. आप सबको मेरे हाथों में ये कागज दिखाई दे रही है? दे रही होगी. तो ये कागज कितना साफ है ना, कोई दाग नहीं है इसमें. ऐसे ही हर एक कागज हम सबको मिली है भगवान द्वारा, जिसे कहते हैं जिंदगी. जी हाँ, जिंदगी एक कोरा कागज है. आप सबने मन के बारे में सुना होगा, मैं कागज की बात कर रही हूँ और जिंदगी की बात कर रही हूँ. मेरा नाम प्रियंका प्रसाद है, उम्र 21 साल, मैं टाटा स्टील जमशेदपुर में कार्यरत हूँ. मुझे भी भगवान द्वारा ऐसा ही एक कोरा कागज मिला था जिसे मैं कई रंगों से भर रही हूँ और आगे भी भरते रहूंगी. मेरा बचपन काफी आम रहा है. मैं राउरकेला में पली बड़ी हूँ, ओडिशा में, और मेरे बचपन से ही ज्यादा दोस्त नहीं थे. मेरा काफी नॉर्मल लाइफ रहा है. और 10th के बाद मैंने 12th नहीं करी. मैंने पापा ने डिसाइड किया कि इसे डिप्लोमा करा देते हैं मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग. मैं हमेशा अपने पापा के बहुत क्लोज रही और मुझे लगता है पेरेंट्स का बात सुनना चाहिए क्योंकि वो आपके लिए हमेशा ही सही डिसीजन लेंगे. चाहे मतलब वह हो सकता है उनकी डिसीजन कहीं गलत हो जाए, लेकिन उनकी ख्वाहिश या फिर उनका इंटेंशन आपके लिए कभी गलत नहीं होता. तो जिस तरीके से पापा ने कहा कि आप डिप्लोमा कर लो मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग में, तो मैंने डिप्लोमा कर ली और मुझे गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज में सीट भी मिल गई. तो जब मैं गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज में गई, वहां पे मैंने देखा कि यहाँ पे तो काफी एकदम कूल सा ग्रुप है, सब पार्टीज पे जा रहे, आउटिंग्स पे जा रहे. तो मेरे पहले से ही ज्यादा फ्रेंड्स रहे नहीं है. मुझे अब भी याद है मेरे कॉलेज में एक ही फ्रेंड थी जो अब तक साथ है. और मुझे कभी भी गम नहीं था कि मेरे ग्रुप नहीं है, फ्रेंड्स नहीं है, मैं आउटिंग्स में नहीं जा रही. मेरा काफी एक नॉर्मल सा लाइफ था. मेरे सुबह 8 से 9 ट्यूशन होते थे, 10 से 5 फिर कॉलेज, फिर आके पढ़ लो, फिर 10 बजे तक सो जाओ. कभी गम नहीं रहा. ऐसे ही 1 साल गया, 2 साल गया, थर्ड ईयर में मुझे इसका फल मिल गया. थर्ड ईयर में हमारी कैंपसिंग होती है टाटा स्टील की, तो उसमें मैं एज ए जे सिलेक्ट हो गई. तो मेरे पास 18 साल की उम्र में ही जॉब थी. तो इस तरीके से मैंने अपनी जिंदगी की कोरे कागज को पहली सफलता से रंगा था. कॉलेज से निकलते निकलते ही एक अच्छी स्टूडेंट थी, तो मैंने कॉलेज सेकंड टॉपर किया और मैं कॉलेज के सेकंड टॉपर बनी विद 90% मार्क्स से. मैंने पास आउट किया, फिर से एक नई जिंदगी स्टार्ट हो गई जमशेदपुर में, आके टाटा स्टील में एज ए जेई. तो एज कम था, सिर्फ 18-19 साल के थे. तो आप जब एक डिपार्टमेंट में जाते हो, टाटा स्टील एक प्लांट है, तो आप जब इतने हार्स वर्ल्ड में जाते हो तो काफी बड़े लोगों से मिलते हो और बहुत ऐसा काम होता है जब आपको समझ में नहीं आता कि हो क्या रहा है. तो मैं भी जब डिपार्टमेंट में गई, काफी सीखने की चाह से गई थी, लेकिन वहां पे तो ऑफिस पॉलिटिक्स इतनी ज्यादा थी कि मुझे समझ में नहीं आ रही थी कि आखिर हो क्या रहा है और मुझे काम करनी क्या है और मुझे क्या नहीं करनी है. मुझे स्टार्टिंग में कुछ समझ नहीं आ रहा था. तो मैंने काफी देखा, जब भी मैं कुछ अच्छा करने जाती थी, 4-5 लोग बहुत बोलते थे, यार तुम ऐसा कर दोगी तो प्लांट को ये हो जाएगा, वो हो जाएगा. तो जाहिर से बात है, जब 18-19 साल की किसी लड़की को ऐसा बोलेंगे वो डर जाएगी, वो काम नहीं करेगी. मेरे साथ भी ऐसे ही होता था. और जब मैं कुछ अच्छा काम करने जाऊं तो 4-5 लोगों को तकलीफ भी होती थी. ऐसे ही काफी ग्रुपिज्म बना, ऑफिस पॉलिटिक्स बना और काफी मुझे साइड कर दिया गया. फिर ऐसे वो लोग पार्टीज करते थे, ट्रीट्स देते थे, मुझे इन्वॉल्व नहीं करते थे. मुझे अब भी याद है, पिछले साल की ये बात है, हम जब प्लांट में होते तो हम गेट पास ले सकते हैं, मतलब छुट्टी ले सकते हैं आधे दिन की. तो मैं हमेशा ना छुट्टी लेके घर आ जाया करती थी क्योंकि मेरा मन ही नहीं लगता था वहां पे, मैं क्या करूँ, ऐसा ही होता था. तो फिर ऐसा मैं, हमारे जो एरिया मैनेजर थे अमेंद्र सर, मैं उनका नाम जरूर लूंगी, वो काफी ही अच्छे मैनेजर थे. नॉर्मली कहते हैं कि मैनेजर काफी हार्श होते हैं, लेकिन वो वैसा बिल्कुल भी नहीं थे. वो एक बहुत अच्छे गाइड थे, उन्होंने मुझे फोन किया और पूछा कि प्रियंका क्या बात है, आप काम पे ध्यान नहीं दे रहे हो, आप घर क्यों चले जा रहे हो? तो फिर मैंने उनको बताया कि सर मुझे पता नहीं चल रहा कि आखिर गलती मेरे से कहाँ हो रही है। तो फिर उन्होंने कहा कि जब आप अच्छा काम करोगे ना तो 4-5 लोगों को तकलीफ होनी ही है, आप सबको खुश नहीं कर सकते, आप बस अपने काम पे ही ध्यान दो। सेम चीज मैंने करा, मैंने दूसरे दिन प्लांट आया और मैं फिर उसके बाद जो 8 से 5 हमारी ड्यूटी होती थी पूरी तरीके से प्लांट को देने लगी, लोगों को नहीं। तो इस तरीके से क्या हुआ, हमारे टाटा स्टील में एक रूल है कि अगर कोई भी एम्प्लॉय अच्छा काम करता है तो उसे सबासी अवार्ड दी जाती है। तो मैंने अपने एक साल के दौरान ही मुझे 2 बार सबासी मिल गए। तो इस तरीके से मैंने एक चीज सीख लिया कि जब तक आप अपने काम पे डिसाइड कर, काम पे ध्यान दे रहे हो, सिर्फ और सिर्फ अपने डेस्टिनी पे ध्यान दे रहे हो, तो आपको कोई रोक नहीं सकता, आपको किसी की बातों का कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ना चाहिए। ये चीज हमेशा याद रखिएगा। और जब भी आप कुछ कर रहे हो, जाहिर से बात है 4-5 लोग बोलते रहेंगे, बस आपको सुनना नहीं है। मैं कुछ लाइन बोलना चाहूंगी, मैंने जो खुद से लिखा है, आप प्लीज सबको सुनिएगा। अकेलेपन की शिकायतें करना छोड़ दो, अकेलेपन की शिकायतें करना छोड़ दो, लोगों ने साथ नहीं दिया ऐसा कहना छोड़ दो। तुम अलग हो गलत नहीं, तुम अलग हो गलत नहीं, मंजिल तुम्हारी है, सफलता भी तुम्हारी होगी, तुम बस लोगों की बातें सुनना छोड़ दो। तो इस तरीके से मैंने अपनी जिंदगी के कोरे कागज को 1000 रंगों से भरा है। मेरे पास बहुत से ऑप्शन थे लिखने के कि मेरे फ्रेंड्स नहीं है, मैंने आउटिंग्स पे नहीं गए, मैं पार्टीज नहीं करती हूँ, मैं घूमने नहीं जाती हूँ, मैं ये सब चाहे तो लिख सकती थी अपने कोरे कागज पर, मैंने नहीं लिखा। मैंने वही सब लिखा जो मैं करना चाहती थी। मुझे जॉब चाहिए था, मुझे जॉब मिल गई, मुझे खुद को रिप्रेजेंट भी करना था इस सेशन में, जैसे स्टोरी टेलिंग सेशन में, और मैं वो कर रही हूँ। तो लकीली मेरे सारे ख्वाब पूरे हो रहे हैं। और तो मैं आप सबको भी यही चीज कहना चाहती हूँ, सिर्फ अपने सपनों पे ही फोकस करें, लोग क्या कह रहे हैं क्या नहीं कह रहे प्लीज उस पर फोकस ना करें, सिर्फ अपने सपने अपने मंजिल पे ही फोकस करें। थैंक यू।
शाबाश। ये शाबाशी मैं आपको क्यों दे रही हूं
आप बता दें।
लोगों की उम्र बीत जाती है बेटा ये समझने में, दैट वी नीड टू लिव इन द प्रेजेंट, नॉट इन द पास्ट और इन द फ्यूचर। ओके, यू आर नॉट लीडिंग अ लाइफ देन, बट इतनी छोटी उम्र में आपने अपनी विजडम से प्रेजेंट में रहकर आगे बढ़े इज अ बिगेस्ट अचीवमेंट फॉर यू फॉर दिस एज, एंड आई वांट टू अप्लॉड यू फॉर दिस।
थैंक यू,
गॉड ब्लेस यू, कीप सोरिंग अहेड। एंड मैं देख रही थी ऑथर शेरी है ना, बहुत केयरफुली आपकी स्टोरी सुन रहे थे, एंड एक कान उनका राइट ईयर आगे था। Sherry, you were listening very carefully to her story. I'm sure you have something to connect with her.
Thank you, Chitra. You rightly said. Priyanka,
yes, sir.
इससे पहले कहीं बोल चुकी हो?
Yes, sir, मैं बोल चुकी हूँ. Actually, आप आरके दास सर को जानते हैं? वो हाँ, उनके द्वारा ही एक स्पीकिंग कॉम्पिटिशन ऑर्गेनाइज हुआ था, तो मैं वहाँ पर भी बोल चुकी हूँ एक बार।
अच्छा, ठीक है, आप थोड़ा सा और मेहनत करो, ठीक है? यू हैव ग्रेट पोटेंशियल, आप में कुछ बात है।
थैंक यू सर,
आगे बढ़ो आप, ठीक है?
थैंक यू।
नौकरी वोकरी धंधा वंदा सब होता रहेगा, इसमें आगे बढ़ो।
सर, आई वुड लाइक टू टेक अ मोमेंट हियर, एंड माय हियर माय स्टूडेंट्स आर आल्सो लर्निंग नाउ बिसाइड मी, एंड व्हेन दे वर लिसनिंग टू प्रियंका स्पीच, दे वर लाइक ऑल कैप देयर माउथ एंड दे वांट टू से हाय टू ऑल, से हाय टू प्रियंका।
Hi. Hi. Thank you.
Suresh, you have got such big students. मतलब इतनी इतनी उम्र के students हैं तुम्हारे यहाँ?
Thank you, Chitra.
Author Sherry. ये प्लेटफॉर्म ऐसा है ना कि मैं अपनी जिंदगी के साथ साथ और बहुत लोगों की जिंदगी भी जी रही हूँ ये स्टोरी सुनते हुए. इनकी स्टोरीज है, इनके एक्सपीरियंसेस है. एंड अब हम बुलाते हैं हमारे अगले पार्टिसिपेंट को, ऑल द वे फ्रॉम फरीदाबाद, मिस अंशिका मिश्रा. अंशिका जी, ओवर टू यू, ऑल द बेस्ट.
थैंक यू. Hi everyone, this is Anshika. I'm from Faridabad. I'm here to share a beautiful story with you all, with which we all can relate, all of us. So please answer me that have you ever been in pain? Maybe due to failure, a personal loss, a tragedy, or a heartbreak. Have you ever found yourself in a situation where you find it extremely tough to handle that pain? A young man who was miserable due to the situation he was in came to an old master and told him about his problems, how he had done everything within his control, how his problems still remain, and how that had caused him so much agony and pain. The master heard him out, gave him a glass of water in his left hand and a handful of salt in his right, asked him to mix the salt into the water and drink it. As the man drank the water, he had a terrible expression on his face. The master asked, "How does the water taste?" "Disgusting, horrible," said the young man. The master then handed the confused young man exact same amount of salt, took him to a nearby lake, asked him to mix the salt into the lake and drink the lake water. As the man drank the lake water, the master asked, "How does the water taste?" "Good, fantastic," remarked the man. "Can you taste the salt now?" "No," said the man. The master said, "Dear son, after we have tried our bit to solve our problems and alleviate our pain, the amount of pain that still remains due to the problem that are beyond our control is like pure salt. You can't change it. It remains the same, unmoved, unfazed, no more, no less. But how we experience that pain, whether or not we experience that pain, depends on the container we put it into. So when you can't change the pain you are in, enlarge your container. Stop being a glass. Start being a lake. And what does it mean to enlarge your container? It means to enlarge your mental abilities by focusing on the good things happening in your life. So when does the salt-like pain seems trivial or non-existent to enlarge the circle of inspiring people around you who add so much value to your life? Does the salt-like pain seems less bothersome or insignificant to enlarge your sense of purpose by focusing on to help others that you do not have you because they are in pain, to help to enlarge the consciousness by a spiritual connection? So when you can't change the pain you are in, enlarge your container. Stop being a silly glass, because if you are silly glass, your pain will remain same like that salt. But when you will be a lake, your pain will be wave out like a salt. Thank you.
What a beautiful story. What a beautiful story, I must say. And yes, हमें एक लेक की तरह होना चाहिए. हमें हमारे horizons, हमारे mindset को बड़ा करना चाहिए. So that छोटी 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 चीजें हमें bother ना करे, shaken ना करके जाए. And बहुत कुछ सीखने मिल रहा है इन बच्चों से आज वाकई में. सीमा जी, आप मैं देख रही थी your expressions and we were very well getting connected with each other, I felt, seeing this story. So what do you have to say here for the participants, for all of us, and how we connect with the story so well?
So Chitra, there's a brain science behind storytelling. So when we are listening to the stories, one, there is something called neural coupling which happens. So the same area of the brain, you know, lights up of the speaker and the listener. And second, the hormones which are produced when we are listening to the stories. So there's dopamine, and dopamine regulates emotional responses and keeps us engaged. Okay. Another one which is released is oxytocin. It helps in build a deeper connections, and it also, you know, evokes a sense of empathy. So, and apart from other hormones which are released, so kuch chemical locha bhi hota hai saath saath sunne se. So that's what happens to us when we listen to stories which are well told.
Yeah, well told. This is something, you know, that the stories go the way they should na, wo log andar penetrate ho jate hain. We start living the life of that character. That's the beauty of storytelling.
I invite Seema to define this well told, by the way. Seema, you have to do this for everybody, please, if you can. I know you are an authority into it. So if you can throw some light. Ki a well told kya hai, right?
Okay, so one is the way the story is structured. There is a flow of the story. There is a genuine, you know, movement from one thing to another. There's connectedness, interconnectedness in the story. Second is the way the person speaks. Okay. True. And third, when the person is feeling and telling,
awesome.
It actually, you know, when it comes from your heart, it'll touch another heart.
Kya baat hai? Great. Superb, Seema. Thanks. Thank you for the value addition.
Nirja ji, is there something that we can do, you know, all of us, we should do before we start our stories or any speech that we do, you know, on the emotional level, that's something we should do before we present ourselves or whatever, in front of 2 people, maybe 10 people or 100 people. Something that we can all of us do, and at all point of time, that can help us. I want to take this away today.
Yes, certainly. The thing to do is to gather yourself together and take some time to be alone by yourself, and don't jump headlong into your storytelling session. So there are a lot of storytellers, a lot of presenters who follow a ritual. Some of them will meditate. Some of them will do some exercise. Some of them will actually go for a run and limber up. So even though the medium is digital, your energy is going through the digital medium. If you're if the blood is flowing through your body, and if you're charged up, your energy definitely reaches even through the digital medium. So it's good to have a ritual and time alone. Shut your eyes and visualize yourself doing the entire narration once. I think that helps. Ideally speaking, there ought to be a ritual. Yes.
Yes, absolutely. There has to be a ritual, and it takes you far, far long way away in your life without having felt guilty or conscious about whatever you're doing. And it really preps you. You know, all the successful people have a ritual, and we should follow. Now, moving on to our next contestant with, again, a historical story, some more things to learn from them again. I invite Ms. Akanksha Bachle from Hyderabad. Akanksha ji, all the best. The stage is all yours.
Am I audible? Hello, everyone, the amazing jury and our amazing anchor and author, Sherry, sir. I'm Akanksha Bachle and I'm 12 years old. And today I'll be sharing a story called The Only Hand. This is a story of a Hungarian man called Károly Tékás. He worked in the army as a sergeant and he was the best pistol shooter of his country. His ambition and goal was to make his hand the best shooting hand in the world. In 1938, there was an army camp going on. And during the camp, an accident happened. A fault hand grenade exploded in his hand. Everyone was shocked. How will he achieve his goal? How will he achieve his ambition when he doesn't have a hand? He was in the hospital for a month, but still they could not save his hand. He lost his only hand, his only shooting hand. He felt like he lost everything, but he had a choice to make. He had two options, whether he will give up and cry for the rest of his life or get up again and focus again on his goal. He chose the second option. He focused on his goal. He focused on what he had. And what did he have? His other hand, his left hand, that hand by which he could not even write. After 1 month and right after he got discharged from the hospital, he started training with his left hand. And after one whole year of training, he came back. He was back. And in 1939, the national championship was being held in Hungary. He went there. All the other participants came to him and said, "Wow, this is the sportsman spirit everyone should have. After everything that has happened to you, you have still come here to cheer us up and to motivate us." He replied, "I'm not here to cheer you up or to motivate you. I'm here to compete with you. So be ready to fight me," he said. The competition began. Everyone was competing with their best hand, but he was competing with his only hand, his left hand. And the question comes, who won? It was the man with the only hand. But he did not stop there. His main focus was on the 1940 Olympics. The 1940 Olympics, for which he had put his blood, sweat, and tears into, were canceled. He was devastated. But again, he took his focus and shifted it towards the 1944 Olympics. But the 1944 Olympics were also canceled due to the Second World War. He again took his focus and shifted it towards the 1948 Olympics. And this time he went there. All the best pistol shooters were there competing with him. They were all competing with their best hand, but he was competing with his only hand. And the question comes, who won? It was the man with the only hand again. But he did not stop there. He went to the 1952 Olympics. And this time, who won? It was Károly Tékás. He was the man with the only hand. There were a billion things stopping him from doing what he wants to, but there was this last hope that he could do it, and he did it. And he made history by winning gold back to back. If you go to a failure, he will have a billion reasons for not trying and failing. And there, if you go to a winner, he will have a billion things stopping him from what he wants to, from doing what he wants to. But there will be one reason that will make him do it, and he will do it. So if you want to achieve success, you should always have that never die attitude. And if you have that attitude and you have that one reason, one last hope, then you will do it. Never be devastated in life. Always have hope. Even if there's only 0.01% hope, but still grab that hope, grab your hard work, and just focus on what you want to do, and you will achieve it. You will do it. Thank you.
क्या बात है, क्या बात है. This story, you know, gave me two learnings actually. One is you are your biggest competitor. तुम्हें बाहर किसी से compete नहीं करना. You have to, you know, compete with yourself each day and grow and grow and grow. And इस attitude से जब हम चलते हैं ना, हम हमारे लिए सब फ्रेंड्स हो जाते हैं, सब इंस्पिरेशन हो जाते हैं, राइट. एंड द सेकंड लर्निंग दैट आई टेक फ्रॉम दिस स्टोरी इज दैट वन थिंग यू गॉट टू टेम, दैट्स इट, एंड दैट इज दिस. इसको एक बार आपने टेम कर लिया ना, आप यू नो वो जो जीत की जिद होती है, आई जस्ट सॉ दैट यस्टरडे एंड आई सॉ द सेम थिंग इन दैट सीरीज ऑल्सो, कि वो जीत की जो जिद होती है वो हम सब सारे हर्डल्स को ओवरकम कर लेते हैं. वाकई में इट वॉज अ वेरी वेरी नाइस स्टोरी. अ बिग राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज टू ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स, टू यू एज वेल. एंड नाउ इट्स टाइम टू गो ओवर टू आवर नेक्स्ट पार्टिसिपेंट. लेकिन एक अनाउंसमेंट है अथर जी, शरी जी आप बोलिए प्लीज.
हाँ, so before you make that announcement, I want to have just a quick chat with these father daughter duo. Satish, are you there? And Akansha, who just performed.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, hi. So first of all, I would like to appreciate both of you, Satish, especially you, for encouraging your daughter. I think this is a great example set by a parent. So my applauses for doing this. And thank you for encouraging India. I'm sure people who are watching us live or who are going to watch us live, this is a great example set by a parent that we should give platform to our kids. Kudos to you for doing this. And I just wanted to acknowledge the same. Great job.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Ab ek important announcement hai sare participants ke liye. Competition ke results. Competition ke results kal announce kiye jayenge. Sharp at 3 p.m. tomorrow in the afternoon. So have good lunch, you know, energize yourself and join us all at 3 o'clock. And the link for bit of it will be shared by Kara ma'am to all of y'all. Kara is somebody who is behind the scenes, but who is creating a fantastic, you know, experience for all of us, a very smoothly going and a very, very warm experience. I want you all to clap for Kara, the unseen hero behind MS Talks and behind everything. You know, I must say, the saying, the hand that rocks the cradle rules the world, is applicable to all the women who are present here and not present here. Now, I would like to invite our next contestant from Chandigarh, again with a wonderful personal story. Mr. Deep Wilson, over to you. Deep ji, all the best.
Well, before I begin, may I know if I'm audible? Thank you. How many of us have the will to excel? Passion to accomplish each moment throughout life. Walk with me this particular moment through my personal highlights, Honorable Chair, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, we all have the zeal to excel. When we are young, we can walk fast, we can run fast. Our own momentum is our inspiration. We don't need an extra push at all. A stage comes in our life when we need that extra push. This memento that I have in my hand always gives me this extra push. This takes me to my school days, the day when I won the most prestigious Shakespeare Prize, all in BCS hall cheered and clapped. I didn't know then that this particular win is going to one day inspire me to go up on stage with my passion to be a speaker. Wow. I recall the time when, in the lawns of St. Stephen's College, Delhi, my brother said, on the day of my flight, when I was going in for a new beginning in the field of education to Muscat, he said, "Deep, no one is indispensable, but make yourself indispensable." I didn't know then that these words are going to inspire me to climb all ladders in my professional career. I didn't know that from the Queen of Hills, I would walk with my crown of life, who would all along in life's journey would motivate me, uplift me, more so when needed most. Yes, think with me this moment. We all are sailing in the same boat. Each one's life is no different. We all have our ups and downs. We are appreciated by people. There are moments that pull us down as well. We need to pull ourselves up in such moments, like William Douglas in deep water pulled himself up, determined to face all odds. Yes, we too have the same determination to pull ourselves up. I recall and I remember the time when in Muscat, every morning in my office, a girl who took permission from me, she was in class 10, she took permission from me to come to my office in the morning, and she wanted to water the plant in my office. After she would have done that, she would thank me. And I always wondered that we, all of us, we want center stage, we want to be in prominence. But look at this girl. She is coming in here and watering the plant. Nobody is watching her. She is not in spotlight on stage. Only me, that's it. And I think she was the one who was excelling, not to be on stage, but yet be on stage. And when in June we were going to have our vacation, she said, "Sir, what are we going to do with this plant? I will take this home and water this. Sir, you're going to India. I will take this." And I really thought that she deserves all appreciation. She needs to be applauded. And then I realized that we all go up on stage to receive a prize. We all win a trophy, but there are students who don't win any trophy. Am I right?
100%.
Thank you. Let's be with all those who inspire. Thank you.
Very, very thought-provoking story, sir. Very thought-provoking story. Or this is very true that sometimes we do oversee people in our lives who do so much without any expectations, absolutely selflessly. And you have reminded us of, you know, such kind of people in our lives. And in, I'm sure, you know, what I'm really going to do now after this is I'm going to thank people from my family because of whom we are here. And they are behind just pushing us like our, you know, our chargers, our energy. Thank you so much for this thought-provoking story, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, sir. You want to say something?
And yes, I would like to here just mention, this is off the record, right? Okay, because my time is up. And this is not a part of the competition as such, right? I would just like to thank author Sherry, who I did have a brief chat with him the other day, and who is really a great motivation to everyone. And I want to thank author Sherry for this. Thank you, author Sherry, for having me here on this wonderful platform. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you for acknowledgement. It means a lot.
Thank you, sir. My coming in means a lot on your platform.
Pleasure.
Now, may I invite our next participant from a beautiful city, from Bengaluru, with a historical story again, Mr. Ajanta. May I invite him to rock the stage?
Hello. Hello, everyone.
I am sorry, Ajanta ji. I am extremely sorry. Aapko Mr. keh diya, your miss. I'm extremely sorry.
It's okay, no worries. Okay. Hello, everyone. Have you heard the story of the marble statue and the marble child? Give a thumbs up or write yes in the chat box. Do you want to hear the story of the marble statue and the marble child? Wave your hand and write yes or no in the comments. Thank you all for your wonderful comments. My name is Ajanta, and today I'm here to share a beautiful story about the marble statue and the marble tile. Thank you for all of your time that you are investing on me. It really means a lot. We will take a good takeaway from this story today. In a beautiful city, there was a big museum, and the floor of the museum was covered with the marble tiles. Amongst the museum, there was a big and a beautiful marble statue. People from all over the world used to come and admire the beauty of the statue. Seeing this, the tile in the museum spoke up with the statue one night. It said, "Hey, statue, do you know that we originally belong to the same place, from the same mine, were transported onto the same sculpture? Yet it is so unfair that people from all over the world are coming to step upon me and praise you. The difference in the behavior of the people is just so unfair." Hearing this, the marble statue replied, "Dear Tile, do you know that we were side by side placed together as the original marble rock? Do you remember that the sculpture chose to work on you first to make you a masterpiece? Do you remember the sharp tools that the sculpture used? Hearing this, the child said, "Yes, I do remember. It was so painful. And how could the sculptor use such sharp tools on me? It was just not fair." Hearing this, the marble statue said, "You are right, my friend. When the sculpture started working upon you, and when you resisted, or when you started falling apart, the sculpture gave up on you and started working on me instead. At that very moment, I came to know that I would be transformed into something very beautiful. So I bore all the hard knocks, sharp tools, difficulties in the life to come out as a beautiful masterpiece. Tile, now that you have left in halfway, you cannot complain about the people stamping over you. Friends, don't you think there is a similarity between this story and the life? Of course, life is a sculpture, and it gives us an opportunity to become a masterpiece by giving hard knocks, sharpened tools, and various difficulties. So it is upon us whether we are ready to take all these challenges and transform ourselves into a beautiful statue, into a beautiful masterpiece, or whether we would crumble and complain like the tile. The choice is upon us whether we want to be inspiring like the statue, or whether we are like the tile where the people stand up upon us. So the takeaway from this story is, allow yourself to the sculpture of the life, where it can give you shape for masterpiece. Take actions so that you can progress towards your goals. Thank you.
Thank you, Ajanta, for bringing out this message. We really, really need to know that, jab tak hum problems nahi face karte, challenges nahi, face karte, tab tak wo jo best hai hamara, it doesn't come out. And you have, brought this out through this wonderful story, and this wonderful little one is so, so good to see here again now.
Thank you, ma'am.
I think she's very happy with her mom's performance, and she's excited to,
Thank you so much.
We are running out of time. I would like to invite our last participant with a story. Somebody from New Delhi with a personal story, with a nice name. Something that keeps coming in my mind whenever I see my, jewelry stuff. So may I invite Kundan Kumar to present a story? Kundan ji?
Yes, I took a few seconds to come out of mute. Thank you so much for a nice introduction, Chaitra. I'll take to remove my chair because I want to stand up and speak. All right, am I visible? Good enough?
Yes, okay. You are.
So, and audible good? All right. So maybe we can get going. Can we start?
It's already started, Kunda.
Yes.
You can.
All right,
continue.
Fine. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. All my friends, wonderful stories. And very new to this group. So let me start. Today, it's all about, a story. I have an apple story. Interesting about this fruit is, you know, with the human evolution, they have been accompanying us quite long, right from Adam and Eve to Mr. Newton, Steve Jobs, to all the doctors around, and then finally to me. So I have an apple story for you. For that, I have to take you 20 years back when it was a time of my adolescence. I was having a lot of friends then, and like most of the parents, my father wasn't very happy with the circle I was having. So especially with one, his name was Akib. He had this habit of getting into troubles, into fights. And then, you know, my father, he used to call me and say, look, Akib is not good for you. He might get into trouble someday. And I said, it's okay, Dad. I tried to take him out of the trouble. And I didn't listen to him. It continued for a couple of months. And then one day my father got a few apples. He put around 4 or 5 of the apples in one of the bag and another 4 or 5 in another bag. And he got a rotten one. And what he did was he put the rotten apple in one of the bags. Of course, he was doing all this in front of me. He called me. So maybe after 3 days, we took the bag out. And to my surprise, you know, the one bag which had the rotten apple were actually decaying. And to the point where it was touching the rotten one. So I was shocked. And the other bag, which didn't have a rotten one, was fresh. It was crisp. So my dad took the moment and he said, look, this is how we humans also operate. If we are in touch with a rotten person, we get rotten at times. That was a kind of shock for me at then. I didn't have any answer, so I just walked away. I took my time. Around after a week, I came back to my dad and I said, Dad, do you remember that apple story? And he said, yes. What happened? I said, Dad, I'm not apple. He said, what? I said, yeah, I'm not apple. I'm a human being. And I have a choice to get affected by something, which is something wrong around me. If my friend is wrong in any way, I can figure out a way to help him or heal him. My dad said, how? I said, Dad, Akib only gets into trouble when I'm not there. If I'm there, I make sure that he doesn't get into trouble. Now my dad was in shock and it was his time to process the thing. Well, across my life, I have seen a similar story has been said in many cultures with the help of a bag of potatoes, a fish in the ball, and a rotten apple. But actually, we take that story as is, and then we start looking for that rotten apple around us. The other statement which says we are the average of 5, yes, we are the average of 5, but somewhere we do not want somebody rotten around us so that that can bring our average down. You know, and we practice it. We practice it throughout our life and keep looking for that rotten apple in order to make ourselves perfect. The impact of that story such happened that actually I started looking more for the rotten apples. And it was just a perception. They were the good people. Nobody looked at it that way. Okay. So, story passed. Coming back to Akib, he's still my good friend. He's doing pretty amazing in his life.
1 minute.
And yeah, and he's doing pretty good in his life. And you know, we are good friends. So finally, before I end this story, I just want to tell you that we are humans and we are more than apples. Thank you. Over to you, Seema.
Kundanji, there was such a deep learning. There was such a deep learning. No? Life is full of choices. It is you who chooses what you want to be, whether you want to be a rotten apple or someone like Kundan. Right?
Oh, much better than me, so yeah, thank you.
So it was a fantastic experience for me and all of us, and we are all unique. This is message that I'm reading in the chat, such wonderful messages that we are getting, you know, through the learnings. Okay, this was, you were our last participant for today.
And I would once again like to thank our sponsors, our digital partners, our media partners for supporting this event, for supporting all of us. And we are looking forward to one more exciting day tomorrow. And I invite you all at 3 p.m. tomorrow sharp, know the results. And let me tell you all, we are not here to compete with anyone. Competition mein winner to chahiye hi, ek, do, teen, whatever. But we all are winners because we put equal efforts, same way that other person has put, and we are learning from and growing with each other. And a big round of applause for MS Talks team for organizing this, to all our participants, to everyone who has been here today to listen to the stories, our honorable jury, and each one of us, we all deserve the clap, the you know, the appreciation for taking out time for each other. This is something that we can give to someone and that is never going to come back. Rest all is going to be there. Over to you, author Sherry.
Thank you, Chitra, for this wonderful performance by you. In fact, we should all applaud you for such a smooth functioning of this entire event. Thank you so much for your wonderful contribution. You have been flawless throughout. And I would like to thank our honorable jury for taking out the time and giving the contribution to the success of each participant today. Goes without saying that we have a day two tomorrow. We'll start with the same time. I can see a couple of participants already from day two are here just to check. And then they're going to perform tomorrow. So all the best to each and everyone who are here. And today we have witnessed some excellent performances. I'm sure jury will agree to this, that there were some rock solid performances. People have followed the basics of storytelling in such a way that I'm sure it will be tough for jury to score them, but I know they will manage. They are pro. All right. So thank you very much once again. Thank you for tuning in to this wonderful digital event of MS Talks. And we will be catching up with each one of you tomorrow at 10:45 a.m. So make sure you log in on time, especially the day two people who are watching this live. Also, at the same time, we would like to thank all our co-sponsors, media partners and digital partners for supporting us. We are already on national media with this event, and I'm sure many people, thousands and lakhs of people have already read about you. Each one of you have participated today. People from US, Dubai, Sri Lanka have participated. So kudos to each one of you. We also have our community publisher, Mr. Vishwa Mohan Singh, joining us all the way from his office. Thank you, Vishwaji, for joining us. He's the founder of Vita Vishwa Publications, and he's been contributing a lot to the success of a lot of community members for helping them publish their books. So thanks to Subhashji for taking out the time and always being a rock solid pillar and support for the entire team. Thanks, Kara. Thank you to all the participants once again. It's time to say goodbye to each one. We are wrapping up on time. We started on time and we will be catching up again live tomorrow. See you then. Bye-bye.
Bye. Thank you. Wonderful.